one. We ready, camera two?
Here comes Joey Russo, kicking things off here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Joey Russo, and I'm here to welcome you to Shockwave episode 3.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, episode 3.
Beautiful sunny day. As I was saying, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the next episode of ESW's Shockwave, episode 3. Tonight, I want to talk about the matches going on. Tonight's main event.
Whoa, Russo.
Well, that didn't take long. Here comes
Austen G. I did not come out here this time to beg for my brother back, because quite frankly, Russo, I'm tired of hearing myself beg you to bring my brother back.
I'm pretty tired of hearing you too.
Give it up for Russo, everybody. I'll tell you what, Russo. I'm not begging this time, boy. I'm demanding it, boy. You see, if you don't give me my brother back right now, I have no choice but to tap you out.
Austen G threatening the boss.
You really want to tap me out?
Oh, I'm going to tap you out, boy.
All right. Well, I'm going to give you something to tap out. All right? How about tonight's match versus the number one contender for that very title? Starts about
a couple hours, right?
Now!
We're gonna get the main event first. It's a submission match for the ESW Shockwave Championship.
That's fine! That's perfect! Put me in the ring with the legend! Obviously not the hardcore legend! It ain't a first blood match! It ain't anything goes! It ain't an ultraviolet like Duke Deathmatch! No, you put me in a baby stipulation! With a bet? I don't think so.
Well, first of all, Austen G, he didn't put you in that stipulation. I made that stipulation. Because I don't need tubes. I don't need chairs, tables, ladders, or anything to beat you, Austen G. All I need are my two hands, and I'm gonna prove that to you right now.
He's a former world champion, and he has a chance to be it again once again. This match is a submission match. There are no pinfalls. You must make your opponent tap out. And again, it's for the ESW Shockwave Championship. It was last week when PL3 made the stipulation.
Why are you trying to hide behind? Sit!
The match begins. Austen G immediately going for a sleeper hold, trying to get PL
already over. Ref, you suck. You suck. I'm tapping him out. He's tapping. Look. No. Oh shit. Stop.
No. PL3 getting out of that right away. Big splash. Dumped in the eye by Austen G, blinding PL3. Now Austen G has control of the match. That didn't last long. Big boot. Austen G flies through the air. Austen G with the takedown. And the ankle lock. Austen G trying to break the ankle of PL3.
He's tapping. What?
But PL3 grabs the rope. Austen G has 5 seconds to let go. PL3 has had ankle injuries in the past, and Austen G knows all about it.
Get up, fat boy! Get up. Come on.
pop-up powerbomb.
Oh!
Ah. But PL3 still hurting with that ankle.
I don't tap. Only to my brother I tap. Oh. Ah.
Go for it.
No, 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 no. Wait! Wait! Oh!
Ah! PL3 once again going for the sharpshooter. And he has it in this time. Will Austen G tap out?
Doesn't look like I'm tapping, you idiot!
Oh, wait a minute. Austen G counters. Austen with the ankle lock. Will PL3 tap out?
Come on, ball boy. Come on.
God damn it!
Once again, rope break.
This bullshit.
Austen G realizing this may not be as easy as he thought.
It's time for you to make a choice, legend. Tap or snap. And I think you want me to break.
Austen G threatening to break the ankle.
Son! Grenade!
PL3 counters and once again with the sharpshooter. Will we have a new champion? Austen G does not have his brother to help him. Oh, but he's got the ankle again. Is he gonna break the ankle?
It's over. Tap out. Tap out.
Rope break once again. Even though PL3 got out of it, there still is damage to that ankle.
13.
Oh, God.
Austen G bringing in a steel ladder.
This one's for you, Roos.
Austen G with the ladder straight to the back.
Say bye-bye to the legend.
The old man getting out of it, and thank goodness this could have been the end of the match.
Didn't even touch me.
Knocking Austen G's head off. If PL3 can pin him, this match will be over. But this is a submission match, so he must make Austen G tap out.
Alex!
PL3 still favoring that ankle.
I don't tap out. And
PL3 using the ladder. Will Austen G tap? Reversal by Austen, and he's back into the ankle lock.
Are you tapping?
And he taps. Austen G is still the champion. The ankle was too damaged. Austen G took advantage. And next week will be Cody Rex versus Austen G.
What's up, everyone? My name is Queen Liz, and my guest for today is Young Rello. Now, young Rolo, earlier this week you said you had something to say to the fans. What exactly is that?
Yes, I do, Liz. Yes, I do. So, the whole reason why I came back to Shockwave and to ESW was because that's what the fans wanted. So, being the guy I am, I decided to give the fans what they wanted. So, I came back at Classic Rolo, the one everybody loved, best friend Simon, everything. I came up short. It's fine, you know, win some, lose some, okay? So, I went back home. I decided, hey, maybe I should be Project Robbery Rolo. Maybe I'll have better luck at Project Robbery Rolo. I mean, you know, we had some good time Project Robbery, so I decided Project Robbery Rolo. What happened? I came up short. So, I went back home again. And then I decided, you know, what's the problem? You know what the problem is? I listen to these idiot fans. That's the problem, Hill. Why do I listen to these guys when I always come up short? Why? What have they ever given me? What have I ever done? I'm tired of listening to idiot fans, the same ones that are watching these videos, telling me what I should do with my career. They wanted to see Simon? Forget Simon. They wanted to see Project Robbery? Where was Callie in my match? Where was Callie when I needed him with Conductor? Huh? Forget that. Forget that! You know what? I'm a new Rolo now.
So this is exactly what I'm talking about, man. This has been going on for weeks now. Where's Jax? Where are we gonna find him? What are we gonna do about this, man?
Hey, I don't really know.
We don't need to worry about Jax Amadeus anymore.
What do you mean don't worry about Jax? Just take that damn mask off. Speak to me. What do you mean not worry about Jax? Where's he at?
Well, let's just say I made some improvements.
Improvements? What do you know about improvements? You're a doctor. You can't do nothing. You can't even wrestle in a ring. If you think you can, face me right now.
I'm the Anarchy champion. I won Circle of Chaos. Are you even extreme? I haven't even seen you in my office. So, before you challenge the Anarchy champion, remember who you're talking to.
I've been in more death matches than you've been here in ESW, baby. But you know what? If you want to get extreme, then let's do it. I'm thinking, light tube death match? I mean, why not?
Why not go into early surgery?
The only person who's gonna need surgery after this is your fat ass.
Try it, Mav.
Gentlemen. I had a main event already scheduled, but let's go ahead and settle this. I don't like what I'm seeing. So you know what? How about we make tonight's main event ESW Shockwave's first hardcore light tube deathmatch. For this belt.
I like that a lot.
Sounds like a deal, Bruce.
Keep that title nice and pretty for me.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Our main event is set. It's a light tube death match for the Anarchy Championship between Cody Rex and the Doctor. That is going to be a crazy match. But coming up next, it's Bruno Magnifico versus Tommy Thomas. Last week, Bruno beat Jake Jordan. Will he beat Tommy Thomas? Up next.
I'm gonna beat this nerd's asses. Did you suck, man? I don't know what the fuck I'm just doing here. Why are you like to see that? Don't you believe that they suck?
Nyla clearly does not want to be here today.
This business is for great people, not for shitty ass people like Buzz's Murph. I don't want you to talk to them like. What
the hell? Bruno's extremely jealous of the nerds. Let's take a look back at what happened last week.
Give me the chair. I need it right now. And I want to hurt him more.
Bruno demanded Nyla give him the chair.
Just give me the...
But she didn't want to. knocking out Jake Jordan with the chair. And then hitting the B Factor. He would have some words with Nyla right after.
You do what I said, okay? We're in this together.
But we're not.
Says who?
We
are.
Did I win the match?
Yeah!
But tonight, the nerds can redeem themselves. Because here comes Tommy Tommy.
Yes, sir. Shockwave. Let's go. Let's go.
Tommy!
You don't deserve Nyla!
You don't deserve to be here, asshole.
I deserve to be here on ESW Shockwave, unlike you!
Ring the bell, fool! You don't deserve to be here.
You're
business, man.
That's what you are.
Nobody knew the history that Nyla and Bruno had. Nonetheless, it does not seem healthy. Down goes Tommy. These guys have been nothing but sleep tonight, and Bruno does not like it. Oh, knock it down, Bruno. Once again, knocking down Bruno. Tommy Thomas may actually win this thing. Nyla looking on the side. She has not seemed happy since Bruno came back into her life. Bruno may tap out here. Bruno got out of that submission right away. Last week, Jake Jordan came up short, all thanks to a steel chair. Back kick by Bruno Magnifico. Oh, and the B Factor. This match could be over.
The man pinning ref.
But Tommy Thomas lives to see another day.
Come on, Tommy.
Bruno just manhandling Tommy and showing off some dance moves. Oh my goodness! Oh no, shades of last week.
You don't have to chair. You don't have to get the check.
No, shut up!
No.
No.
You have to.
No.
No.
Dame la silla.
No, stay right.
You shut
Jake
up.
Jake Jordan is pleading. No.
Give me a chair.
Don't give him the chair, Nyla.
Give me the chair.
I don't think I should.
Well, you should. Give me the chair.
Don't give him the chair. No.
Jake Jordan's pleading, Nyla, not to. Wait a minute, a roll up.
Two, three.
Yeah. He got him. The nerds win. I can't believe it.
Come here. Get out of here.
What's wrong? What did you get there? I thought we were a team. We're supposed to kick their asses or not.
Tú haces lo que yo te digo, ok? ¿Entendiste? Que no se repita la próxima vez.
Someone really needs to help Nyla. I feel so bad for this beautiful woman.
This month on Patreon, it's Backyard March Madness. Every weekend, we upload a classic full backyard wrestling event for our extreme and wicked tier supporters. Don't miss out on Backyard March Madness all month long on Patreon. Check us out on patreon.com/ESW Shockwave.
That looks good. That looks really good. I like our analytics as well. January's usually not so bad. Jerome, how are you, sir? Welcome to ESW. What can I do you for?
Where's the conductor?
All right, I figured it was a matter of time before you came in here. Now, I know he attacked you. at the pre-show, and I get it. I know exactly what it is that you want. But my guys, my medical guys, they're telling me that you're not 100% okay yet, all right? If everything looked good, if everything looked perfect on paper, I would do it. But until you're cleared, I cannot give you a match with a conductor. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. I just need you to be patient with me right now. All right? What do you say?
Whoa, I would not want to be the conductor tonight. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jesse Garcia. Speaking of the conductor, he is on his way to the ring right now. So let's go ahead and join him. Well, we know Jerome is here today. Will we see an encounter between the conductor and Jerome? Conductor has made it very personal with Jerome. Conductor has not been happy with anybody who has left ESW and come back, Jerome being one of them guys. This man is solely responsible for ending the career of Draven Cross. And you just saw Young Rolo tonight. He changed the way he thinks. Conductor is capable of so many mental games. Why would they label me heartless when your love is my cocaine and your soul is my
Rogaine? I have a thirst to know your brain. Well, here I am, ESW Shockwave. All I've been hearing is why, Conductor? Why? Why did you assault Rolo like that? Why did you end Draven Cross's career? Why did you attack Jerome? Jerome, of all people. I returned at the Wicked J tribute, and what did you people do? You people laughed. You people sat on your hands while all these comeback kids came in and we welcomed them back with open arms. Well, guess what? ESW, the ESW fans, you broke my heart. And now I'm going to break yours by destroying each and every one of your heroes. Jerome! Where are you, Jerome? Come on out!
Will we see Jerome?
Okay. Yeah, okay. He's probably eating his fine fruits, his watermelons, his grapes, his pineapples.
There he is! Jerome is here! And he knocks Conductor out of the ring. Jerome has probably been waiting for this since the pre-show. Jerome lost the ESW title match. And it was all thanks to Conductor. He's got a chair on the wall! Oh, chair shot to the back. Another shot to the back. Jerome could have been ESW champion. Thanks to Conductor, that didn't happen. Wait a minute, here comes Russo.
I need you to wait a second, just calm down. I just brought you back, I need you to hold on. I just got you back here. Think about what you are doing before you do it.
Oh, concerto! Conductor's knocked out. Jerome finally getting revenge, but at what cost?
There are repercussions for things like this, Jerome! Nobody walks all over me anymore!
I have a feeling these two are gonna collide eventually.
Where were you geeks 2 minutes ago? Well, help me up, you lowlives!
Hey, what's up? Yeah, bro. It's estaba hablando para pedirte un favor la próxima semana. ¿Sí? ¿Puedes venir? Okay. Well, I'm tired of the nerds already, okay? I want to get done with them. I want to finish them for once and for all. Are you down? Cool. Gonna destroy them. And you? I'm tired of you. I'm done with you, okay? You're done with ESW. Get the fuck out of here now.
What's up, everyone? My name is Queen Liz, and tonight my final guest is Cody Rex.
Y'all reach, you got something there. Right now I'm out of hunting, so obviously my phone is off. This is important. Leave a message. No, for sure.
Now, Cody Rex, up next, you're in a light tube death match. What is your game plan?
Liz, there's not really a plan that I have tonight. This was all stunning for me.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it really was. Actually, came out here to tell you good luck, Cody. Good luck going out there and making a fool of yourself. You think you're hardcore? You ain't hardcore. I'm hardcore. So go ahead and get yourself in a position where you can't compete next week against the champ. Because if you can't compete, then I won't compete. And I will still be the world's heavyweight champion. Why not?
I don't know about you guys, but I've never seen Cody Rex this in focus. I mean, next week he has a title match, but tonight he puts himself in a death match? He's worried about Jack? There's so many more important things that he should be doing. Nonetheless, up next is Cody Rex versus the Doctor for the Anarchy Championship, and that match is a light tube death match. And there comes the Maverick. This man next week will face Austen G. That's if he can survive this death match. Light tubes have been placed all over the ring. Referee forced to wear safety gloves. This match is gonna be intense. It's gonna be bloody. And here comes the Anarchy Champion. Here comes the Doctor. Cody Rex worried about his friend Jax. That's what led him to this match. Come to think of it, if Cody Rex wins, he'll be the Anarchy Champion. And if he wins next week, he'll hold both championships.
Ring the bell.
Come on, Maverick. What are you waiting for?
Ooh, running into a brick wall. The Doctor's so much bigger than Cody Rex. Oh my goodness! Cody Rex went chest first in the light tubes. And now he's got a crutch with a light tube on it.
Hey, you might actually need this afterwards.
Oh! These stains can cut you into a million pieces.
Up and over!
And over the top we go. What is that? That is a huge cabin of lightning. This match is gonna be extreme.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, huge drop kick taking the doctor down. Oh, back body. The doctor stumbling to his feet. Over 100 light tubes have been placed all around the room. Oh my goodness! Shoulder first goes doctor. And now Cody Rex grabbing more light tubes. Light tubes shattering over the back of the doctor.
You want a death match? Tell me I'm not hardcore, bitch! Tell me I'm not hardcore! I'm a goddamn maverick!
There's the Cody Rex we know. Oh, but he's caught. So many light tubes everywhere. Oh, a light tube just exploded over his head.
You had this coming for a long time, Doctor.
Cody Rex bringing another light tube set. Oh my goodness! And an uppercut! Glasses everywhere.
Oh. You want to bring one? I'll bring you one.
And there comes another light tube set. There's four light tubes set up like a tic-tac-toe. Oh, juice drop kick. Oh! The doctor may need a doctor after this.
One, two, two.
Cody Rex setting up those light tubes in the middle of the ring. That's Cody Rex's opponent next week. Oh my goodness, punt to the skull. Austen G is out here and it's all legal. What is he doing now?
Up.
How many light tubes is that? Oh no! This may be the biggest light tube cabin in history.
Grenade!
The grenade! He goes to the tube. And the doctor retains his championship. But is Cody Rex okay?
You ain't never gonna see this, boy. Not next week. Not next month. Not next season.
I said you're not hardcore.
Cody Rex is out. Call. We need to get some help out here.